Oh, yeah, oh.
Just I'm gonna start with some saute.
Go ahead, be crazy.
Yeah.
Anyone can do this. And oh, yeah, oh. Show the world you've got that fire.
We're gonna jump in first. One and a two and a three and a four and a second and a six and a seven and a eight and a first, two, three, four and second, six, seven, eight. Yes. And we're gonna be it. Back, be it. Front, be it. Back, be it. Front, other way. Be it. Yes, makes sense. First eight, second eight, first eight, second eight. Then you first. Ready? Five, six. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 7, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, back to first, 1, 2, 3, back, 6, 7, 8, second, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, VA, back, VA, front, VA, back, VA, front, other way, back, front, back, stretch it out. Legs are warm now. Good job. Okay. We're going to take our right foot behind us in forward position. Okay. Front pull up. Passe. Going. Plie. Passe. Eight times on the right, eight times on the left. Six, seven, and plie. One, plie. Two, plie. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Other foot in the back. Five, six, seven, and plie. One, plie. Two. Apply on that toe. Four, five, six, seven, eight. Same thing in turn out. Okay. I need to sing more releve. Sing a lot of rocking, ball change. I need you up on our toes because that's where we turn. We don't turn on a flat foot. So you need to be lifting from our plie to the back. This foot comes forward. I'm going to my releve, set it back down. Yes, and you should be fighting to get higher. So on my good hip, yes, my baby toe is just beneath my kneecap and pulling back, okay? I don't want down here and I really don't want my foot to go that way. Really want to pull it up instead of under my knee. Should feel a rotation here, and my knee is going back that way, okay? We're gonna start with our right foot behind us, reaching towards the front. We're gonna do eight, just like we just did, but in turnout. Exact same thing, in releve, turnout.
Miss Marissa?
Yes, ma'am.
Yesterday, I hurt my arms because I fell off my electric scooter.
And oh my God.
It hurts when I go up, and it hurts when I straighten this elbow.
Okay, when you go up on your toes, or when you reach your arm up?
When I reach my arm up, and it when I out here, it hurts.
And why don't you? Can you just take and put your hands on your waist and focus on your knees? That way, we're not injuring ourselves more. Does that sound okay? So don't reach. Yeah, don't reach and then pull. Just kind of stay right here, or if you need to cross them in the front, if that's safer, do that.
Because my elbow, it really hurts when I straighten it.
Okay, don't straighten it. Yeah. Just do what you can do, okay? All right, here we go, guys. Oh, music, here we go, some music. Right foot back. Five, six, seven, and plie, passe, plie, two, three, four, five, nice round arms, six, seven, eight, switch feet, five, six, seven, and plie. plie, up, plie, two, plie, three, four, up to those toes, five, squeeze the booty, back, seven, and eight. There we go, that was good.
Molly, get rid of that blanket.
Okay.
Not you.
Okay, good. Because I didn't hear you. Be careful on these arms. When you go to pull up, we're kind of breaking. Ooh, pokey elbows. So when we pull those arms, we want to just this arm that's reaching. Sorry, I've been really cold today. This arm that's reaching, all I want to do is rotate. So I'm reaching like this, and I'm just going rotate, and this arm comes to meet it. I don't pull this arm toward me as I turn. So I want this reach. So try that with me other than broken Emma. Don't do this. Everybody else, just reach your hand in front of you. Just rotate to round. And then bring the other one to it. I feel like that's going to feel very different for a lot of you because that's not what I'm seeing. I'm seeing a lot of pull to get the arms in. So I don't care. Do parallel, do turnout, do right leg, do left leg. Let's do four with the correct arm. Okay, so reach the arm out in the front and just rotate the wrist. Ready? Pull it up, then set it down. Just four times. Focus on those arms. Good. There we go. Keep that extension. Don't pull in, Logan. Keep it round, round, round. Yes. I don't know why, but this, I don't know, this might sound weird. It comes out in my boys a lot because you guys have this like need to be very strong. And so we really pull hard. And then some of my really athletic, acrobatic dancers, like Mara, and I used to talk about this a lot. She's very athletic. She has fantastic turns, but she used to pull way too hard. So I'm seeing it a little bit in my acrobatic dancers and in my boys who tend to just pull too hard sometimes. So be careful of that because that's something I'm going to be correcting on you until you're, you know, 18 or whatever, and you run away. Okay, so let's try all of those corrections, those beautiful placements. We're going to stay in turnout, and we're going to do our quarter turns. A quarter is 1/4, like 4 quarters make a dollar, okay? So we are going to do 4 turns to make 1 rotation, 1 full turn. So you're going to pick your right foot up first, and we're going to turn toward it, set it down. And we're going to do it again. Pick it up, set it down. Pick it up, set it down. Pick it up, set it down. We're going to do 2 whole dollars, 2 times around to the right, 2 times around to the left. Okay? So 8 turns or 8 passes to get our 2 turns. Okay? Let me get a different song pulled up. Not that one. This one sounds good. So get that left foot in the front, right arm reaching towards the front of the room, and pick a quarter, plie, quarter, plie, quarter, plie, quarter. Do it again. Ready? Squeeze that belly button. 2, 3, 4.
I had a dream of
Bras de Jean. 5, 6, 7.
You were stuck inside.
Quarter. Two, three, four. Like it. 1, 2, 3, 4. I meant to say this earlier, so pause for a moment as human beings.
Love isn't all. That
Miss Marissa's yucky hip is really hurting with all the rain. So you are not going to hurt my feelings. I didn't spotlight my video tonight on purpose. If you want to pin one of our teachers, like Miss Selena's over there, Miss Eliza's over there, Miss Morgan's over there, Miss Maddie's over here, Audrey's there, I don't know, Grace is there. There are a lot of older teachers that they don't have cuckoo hips like me. And if you would rather watch someone not bobble every time they pick up their left foot, pin them. Push the little dot, dot, dot in the corner. Pin them up so they're your spotlight video. You can watch them and let them be your example for tonight, okay? Because I will be leading you, but I'm hurting a lot. So you're going to see me bobble. You can watch me. It's fine. giving you notice. Now, that being said, going through these, when we go up, we need to think about, what am I seeing? I'm seeing your chest lifting this way. So we want to think about lifting from here as I come up to my leg at the top of my head, and I'm seeing us pull here. And when you're only doing a fourth of a turn, if you pull forward, it makes you it hiccups. Everything goes as we're getting up there, because you're having to stop this intense, strong momentum that you don't need, and you should never use your chest as your momentum, okay? Your momentum comes from your core and from lifting up really tall. I really need one of those string things, so you guys, I probably could have gotten one at Easter time. There's this game from year 24 of life, and there's a little button in the middle, and you pull the two strings, and it just spins and spins and spins, and it's because there's tension from the top and the bottom. That's exactly how you spin as a dancer when you do it well. I will work on that. I will Amazon that. So you have a visual of that, because probably no one gets those for Easter anymore. We used to. So try to think about pulling here and pressing down when you pull up, okay? One of the best workshops I had this year was at...
Miss Marissa.
Yes, ma'am.
What leg are we supposed to be up? What leg is supposed to be up?
The first time, the first eight is on the right leg up. And the second eight is our left leg up. So we're switching. We're doing two full rotations on the right and two full rotations on the left.
So okay. We go the opposite way of Morgan. So we go the opposite way.
If she's facing you, right? Because she's facing toward you. But you know what? It's okay if you do your left and then your right, as long as you do eight on one side and then eight on the other side. If that's confusing to switch sides, that's okay. Just stay on one side until you're done and then go to the other side, okay? Good? Okay. So one teacher I took from at the last convention we went to, and I can't think of, was that Tremaine? He was a contemporary teacher, and he talked about how much he learned from when his teacher taught him to push into the floor when he turned, as opposed to thinking about going around. And so that was something that really stuck with me. So I always thought, Miss Aaron always told me to pull up from here, but when he talked about pushing down into the floor, it reminded me of all the contemporary classes I had where we talked about grounding. So I think when we're turning, we think so much about spinning and lifting that we don't stay grounded, right? We get off of our 3 points of attachment, because we still have two of our points on the floor. So we still want our big toe and our baby and the ball of the foot under the baby foot still attached to the floor, okay? So when we do this time, I want you to think about pushing into your foot so that our knee draws up, and then lifting from the top of your head as we rotate. So your core stays in the center as we turn, and nothing goes this way as we go around, okay? Yes, my younger dancers just really focus on picking up the right foot and going the right direction. My older dancers, please take all of that and put it into your body as if we were standing in front of you, as boring you with my normal lectures, okay? So let's do this. Stand up, quarter turns, eight on the right, eight on the left, and then we're gonna switch to half turns.
It seems I did you wrong.
Six, seven, plie, up.
Two,
push down, three, four, again, one,
been
two,
wandering all night,
three,
try to take
four,
lost and roll,
switch feet,
make it right.
Five, six, seven, plie,
up,
two, push down, three,
close to the five,
four,
but it's the only
five,
place
that six,
I can hold you tight.
Seven, eight.
Ooh.
Oh, that hurt. Okay. Half turns. Any questions? Are we good? No? Half turns. Okay, so all that changes is how many turns we get to go full around. So now I'm going to face the back of the room. Front of the room. Okay. We're going to do four sets. So we're going one and two. To four, and then other foot. Ooh, get dizzy trying to do those things. Here we go.
That it seems I
five, six, reach that toe behind, and face the back, face the front, Face the back. Face the front. That's two. Up. Three.
Been wandering all night.
Four.
Try to take.
Make sure we're turning out. I'm seeing our feet start to rotate into parallel. Six, seven.
Up.
Two. Squeeze.
Too close to the five.
Four.
But it's the
only
that was
two.
Squeeze. Hold you tight.
Up. Last one.
In this burning path. Lazy get
in there. Do you guys feel confident in your space doing a single full pirouette without hurting yourselves? Yes, I'm seeing nodding, so we're going to give it a go. If you do not feel comfortable doing a single full pirouette, you can stay with half turns. Okay? Whatever you feel comfortable with. We are going to do four. So we're going down, one, down, two, yes, four, round de jambe, other side, one, two, three, four. Here we go, right foot back, five, six, tendu, plie, one, two, three, four, switch feet, five, six, tendu, plie. One, two, three, four. Man, I have a hard time watching those while I'm doing them. Mr. Alex, do you see anything we should be talking about? No. I'm having a hard time seeing.
I was muted. The thing that I see the most is we're leaning forward over ourselves instead of standing up really tall. We're folded at the waist in our prep, and then when we lift up, we're straightening on the base leg without getting the shoulders over the tops of our hips. That seems to be the most common stacking issue that I'm seeing.
So you're seeing this?
A little bit, yeah.
That shape? Okay. So, pulling up. Everybody just go to first position for me. Feet planted on the ground. And I want you to pull up onto a releve as high as you can get in first position. Arms in first. Lift your body, pull your belly button into your spine. Now I want you to shift onto your right leg and just lift your other foot off the ground. And set it down. And shift, not all the way down, just back to first. Releve, releve, squeeze your belly button. And down. Let's do that again. Pull up, and press down. Ready? Over. Lift. And set it down. Back. We're still in releve first. We haven't put our heels down yet. Now go the other way. Lift. That one foot off the ground. Just flexing through that foot. And come back down. Okay. So the more you have to shift to do that, the less successful you are going to be in turns. Okay, so it's like an, I don't remember what that's called, an inverse equation, right? You guys are all doing math right now. So the more I have to move, the less chance my turns are going to be good. If I can find my center and shift just to the other big toe, I'm going to have a way better chance of being able to turn there than if I have to like, to get to the other foot. Okay, so try that one more time. See if you can shift inches as opposed to body widths. Okay, so start in a strong first. Get your heels right underneath your belly button. They should be connecting in line with your belly button. Press into your toes to lift. Push down to lift up. And then pick a leg, lift it off the ground. Set it back down at your own speed. That's just how long I could hold it that time. And come back down. That's my bad turn side. Squeezing. Don't let the heels come down. So part of this is just building calf endurance. And just shift from side to side. Yeah, Audrey, you could do it through passe too. But a little slower would be better. So if you could exhale and pull the foot up and then set it back down still in releve. And do the other one. And set it back down still in releve. Try a couple of those. I like that. Just go slower. Stay on your releve. Don't put your heels down, like, at all. Stay there. Smaller steps apart, Reagan. You're going to second position. Kaylee, same thing. Stay in first position. Keep that first. Squeeze your tuchus. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Stretch it out a little. This is a long time on your quads or on your calves. Your quads are fine. So the backs of your legs should feel nice and warm. I mean, it shouldn't kill you, but it should feel nice and warm back there now. Perfectly warmed up. Make sure, I feel like those are good challenges. make sure you give this a go. But really what I was trying to say is like, if you're gonna challenge yourself to something like that, don't pick it up once and then set it back down and be like, I wasn't that good at it, right? So like, you pick it up and you're like, okay, well that was not my best. Let's see. I mean, you can, not that you're going anywhere. I was about to say, you can do that standing line at the grocery store, but you don't because you're not old enough. They won't let you in the store right now. But just a good thing to kind of like get our hips nice and strong. Okay, so those are our full turns. I want to take those full turns and turn them into pencil turns, which is not a big change, right? All we're doing on a pencil turn, which I think people get confused on, is picking our foot up in the back. So here, I'm sorry, mirror you. Your right foot's behind, and I'm gonna take my rotation to this leg. So I'm gonna squeeze my inner thighs, and I'm gonna go, and my leg's gonna come together. I am not going kick. It's not a kick. It's a squeeze of my inner thighs, okay? So by the time I get to the back of the floor, I'm in a dégagé, so my foot is just off the ground. This is not a float, this is not waist high, okay? This is a dégagé. So I'm gonna make my foot connect. My legs are gonna almost cross. They're gonna squeeze so hard, I'm gonna go squeeze and come down. What I want you to do, if you're maybe past your first year of doing turns, I want you to try to balance, do a single pencil and see how long you can hold the balance at front. So you're going from the back and you're going, hold, and see if you can say that was my bad leg. So you go, squeeze, oh, okay, I don't have a good leg on these. All right, so everyone, we're doing pencil turns. We're gonna start by going 8 on the right, 8 on the left, like we did with music. And then I'm gonna let you go on your own and see if you can hold that squeeze releve in pencil, okay? In dégagé, not in a pencil. You are not a pencil.
I've been sleepwalking.
Frozen. Ready? Five.
You're gone. We can't see you.
You're frozen.
6, 7, 8. Ooh, fuzzy socks and carpet. That's a fun combo. Here we go. 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Keep going. Fight for it. 8. That it I'm seeing some drag turns. It's not an outside pirouette. I've got to. So I just told you, you have to go pick your leg up, right? My leg's behind me here. I have to go toward that leg to pick it up. I can't go this way. Then my leg's following me, okay? So when you turn, it's like a little.
You're gone.
Have we been working the same side the whole time? Let's switch over to the other. If you haven't switched and worked the other side yet, let's switch over to the other side. Make sure you're Yes. Make sure you're pulling up on your base leg and straightening that leg that's out in front of you on that pencil. Don't let them be lazy straight. Pull up on the muscle on top of your knee and make sure you're actually getting a good straight leg on there. You're back.
Okay. Well, I gave you a whole exercise that nobody knows about, so I'm going to say it again. We're going to go from our pencil to a plie to a single tour, right? So we worked on our tours last week. We did these last week. Yes, Allie says yes. I'm going to go with you. Yeah, I did. And we're going to do a single pencil. And what we talked about last week with those tours was getting the ankles to squeeze together on the landing of the tour. So we're gonna challenge that. We're gonna start with just the pencil and then the tour, and then we're gonna move up to a pencil, a tour, and then a single turn. So lots of rotating. Okay, so let's start with just trying a pencil into a tour. So we're gonna start with that right foot behind us, and we're pushing off into the pencil turn, stepping it down, taking it around. Let's try that, ready? All together, toe behind, set it down, pencil turn, plie, tour, down. Nice, do that again. I saw some good ones, ready? Tendu, plie, and turn, plie, and tour. If we're falling towards the camera, we're doing the banana that we've talked about so many times. When we go to do the tour, it's like this way, okay? One more time on the side. Tendu, plie, pencil turn, plie, tour. Okay? If you're falling backwards, you're probably doing the opposite. You're getting your arms behind your ears instead of right in front of your hands should be right in front of your forehead, pressing straight up this way, okay? Try the other side, ready? Left toe behind, tendu, plie, pencil, plie, tour. There you go, do that again. Tendu, plie, pencil, plie, tour. Nice, I'm gonna change my screen because this screen looks real good. And,
nice.
Tendu, plie, pencil, plie, tour. Good job, do it again, ready? Tendu, plie, pencil, plie, tour. Good. All right, you want to try the harder one and take it a step up? Yes. So we're going to go. Tendu, plie, turn, plie, tour, woo, plie, turn.
Charlie, pick up your other foot when you're turning. Make sure whichever direction you're turning to, that's the leg you're picking up. So if you're turning towards your left shoulder, pick up your left leg. Right shoulder, right leg.
So I was
Alex, can you count that? All of her toe just busted open.
Yep. Ready?
Good.
Six, seven, eight. Not gonna say it, you know what you're doing. Turn and. All right, let's try it again. Ready? Right side, five, six, seven, eight. Down, turn, up, set, turn, down. Let's make sure we're using our plie on starts and finishes and the in-betweens. Everywhere we need to stop or begin is where we want to use our plie. That's going to give us our power and our ability to finish something, okay? Make sure we're tightening in that. Yes, ma'am.
So are we doing this leg or this leg? Because
right now we're doing
that way.
Yes, right now we're doing your right leg. So the way you just pointed, that is the leg that you're using.
This leg?
No, ma'am.
This one?
Yes, ma'am. All right, ready? Make sure we're keeping that core engaged. Five, six, seven, and. Turn, and, turn, and. Okay, that last one's a full passe, right? I'm not crazy. It is, yes? Okay, so I'm watching a whole bunch of parallel coupes. Not real attractive. Make sure you're picking that knee all the way up. When we're doing a parallel turn, another way we describe that is a tabletop. If your tabletop looked like that, you wouldn't be able to set anything on top of it. It would be a pretty terrible table, right? Let's do two more times on the right. Ready? Five, six, seven, eight. Turn, down, up, set, turn, down. Ready? Five, six, seven, eight. Plie, plie. All right, get ready for your left. I know some of you are watching your screens, but if your screen's down low, that's not a good place to spot. Make sure you're spotting at least at your eye level or higher, yes? Okay, ready? Left side. Here we go. And five, six, seven, eight. Again, five, six, seven, eight. Personal pet peeve, when you finish turns, I really, really hate it when your arms go limp like noodles and swing around you like a washing machine. It's like one of my very least favorite things that happens with dancers. You can ask some of the ladies and gentlemen here. It drives me nuts. So let's try really hard when we're finishing that last turn, especially, that we're getting our hands down to clean. All right, ready? Left side again. And five, six, seven, eight. Lift, plie, lift, plie, lift. Oh, God, older dancers, you're as bad as the younger dancers about letting your arms go all over the place. And people I legitimately think of as like better dancers than me have their arms go all over. All right, you're killing me. All right, ready? Left side, set, five, six, seven, eight, plie.
Oh, I see something.
Please.
When you guys are, because I was doing it with you, but I got done before you, and I think the big reason is that you're set. Okay, so this is my front right now. So I go here and here, here, and you guys are going from here to here. Like we're taking steps.
I was just about to ask about that because I saw a bunch of them doing that and I didn't think that's what it was. It should just be plie turn, plie turn, plie turn, right?
Yeah, so basically you're having to use the plie from the landing of your tour as the prep for your turn. That was the whole point. So if you're taking a ball change into it, that's not using the plie from your tour. We want to go from the tour to the turn. That's the exercise. So can you try just a couple tour turn where you don't take any extra steps on your own? You do. Tour, pirouette. Tour, pirouette. Just seeing so many extra steps. I think turn the other way, Adriana. I can't see which foot you picked up, Princess. Uh-huh, that was a good tour. Okay. All right. Did you feel at least a difference when you tried to take away the steps?
What is a pirouette?
That's our turn. Okay. That's okay, that's fine. Sometimes I say words that I don't say as often as other turns. So that's our inward tour in this moment. A pirouette is anytime we spin on one foot. Okay, so big deep breath, that was a lot of turns. That's a lot of turns. Last week we worked on our tilt, right? We didn't work on our pitch. So what I want to talk about today that we do in class all the time is the difference between our hinge and our pitch and give you a chance to work on both. So coming through our hinge diagonal, squeezing through, hitting our pitch downstage and into it, okay? So this one should not, it takes up about a square, so you should be okay. If you were able to turn, you're probably fine in your space on this one because it doesn't travel side to side really. We make it travel side to side at class, but this one doesn't really travel. So start by stepping on your left so you can kick right, okay? When we step on our left, yes, on our left, we're reaching our left arm up as well, same arm as leg. Kick that leg, remember it's a batma to your shoulder, so we're going here, but because it's a hinge, I'm looking at my bottom hand and my knee is staying up towards the ceiling. Then that leg from my hinge is going to scoot new over. I'm gonna step on my left leg again, and then I'm going to let my hips stack up and pitch kick. So I'm gonna go step, pitch kick this way. And this is one of the ones that, who has space? Grace, could you do this one real fast? You have space. You can do whatever leg you want. I won't be mad at you. Whatever leg you want, Princess.
Miss Grace.
Just go hinge, step, pitch.
Emma, just do what you can, buddy.
And pitch. See how her hips change shape? Yeah. Who had a question? Sorry. Thank you, Grace. Who had a question? We're good? Okay. Emma, don't use your arms, right? All about your legs on this today. All right. So here we go. Mine is not a good example. Feel free to watch somebody else. We are stepping. We are hinging. We are sutenu. Step, pitch, land. Good. Okay, so on our pitch, don't take a bow so much. Like, we want our hips to stack, but we don't want our head to go all the way sideways. I just want to kind of, when I teach these, sometimes I call it a peekaboo, because your foot is coming right on the inside of your face, and then it comes right back down again. There are kicks that take a, and then you drop your body farther, and that's a different, it's almost like a planche, but sideways. It's just another way to show off your flexibility. But for Ms. this
Marissa,
yes.
Whenever we do the hinge kick, could we use a chair, or are we just gonna use it without?
Do the what?
Are we gonna be using chairs, or are we just gonna be doing it without chairs?
If you need a chair, you can grab one, but you can do it without a chair too. This is just a bot mount. So anywhere above your waist is perfect. So if you want to use a chair, you're welcome to. Yeah? Okay, so let's try a couple in a row. So you're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, pitch, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, pitch, 6, 7, 8. Let's do 4. We'll take a breath, we'll do the other leg. Here we go. 5, 6, 7, 8. Step, hinge, pivot, turn, step, pitch, together. 5, 6, so you're not covering, ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, reset. 6, 7, 8, go. 1, hit 2, 3, 4, 5, pitch, 6, 7, 8, reset. 6, 7, 8, 1, hit 2, 3, 4, 5, hit 6, 7, 8. Was that 4? Was that 3? That was 4. Audrey says 4. She's used to counting for me. Okay, let's do the other side, and then we'll go over some comments. Here we go. 5, 6, 7, we go. 1, hit 2, 3, 4, 5, pitch, 6, 7, 8. Again, 6, 7, 8. 1, hit 2, 3, 4, 5, pitch, 6, 7, 8. Step back, 6, 7, 8. 1, hinge 2, 5, hit 6, 5, 6, 7, and 1, hit 2, 5, pitch 6. Good, Lynn, that was a nice pitch right at the end. Good job, you guys. Mr. Alex, did you see anything specific? I saw a lot of nice pitches. We still need a lot of love on our hinges.
I got stuck on the base legs being straight, if I'm being perfectly honest.
Okay, so your base legs were ugly. If you can't look at anything else, that means y'all are kicking like this.
And then the in-between, there's a lot of very off balance after we kick. Kick doesn't do you any good if you give up your control to do it.
Right. Yeah, a batma should have all the control. You should be able to do a batma without coming off balance. Should be, right? So if that's something you're having a hard time with, I'm giving you a nice lunge batma. That's like one of the most controlled kicks we get to do as dancers. Most of the time, you have like, ready? We're going 1, 2, 3, 4, kick, 6, right? Like you have nothing. But you get to go like reach and kick, yeah? So when we come back down, I get to button it all back up. Ooh, maybe that's what's messing them up, Alex, that bent knee. So when they go like this, they don't have as much space to catch themselves when they're landing.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Okay, so maybe that's what's happening, dancers. So that is not an easy fix, but it is fixable. When you go to kick that leg, if we squeeze, press into the floor, if we're pressing into the floor, that gives us space to swing that leg through it and land gently, as opposed to my knee being, oh, my leg just, if you didn't see my camera shake, that is what just happened. My foot just sandwiched right into the floor. So do a hinge on your own and think about zipping up your core, like literal zipper on your jacket as you come down, not as you're going up, as you're coming down. Do a couple. Use that use that visual for me. Zip up your jacket as you come down. See if that helps at all. Zip up. That was better, Bree. Adelie, don't let both arms come up. So you want one arm up to start and then drop it diagonal, okay? Good, a little bit more over your toe, Audrey. Don't lean away from it so much. Yes, much more control. Dia, a little bit more, a little more reach. Adriana, can you look at your bottom hand instead of your top hand on your Batma? Look at the one by the floor. Good, Miranda, good fix. Shire, are you looking at your bottom hand when you kick? You're looking at the camera. Can you look at the hand that's reaching, this one down here? So you're kicking in front of you. You need to kick to your shoulder, not towards the front. Yeah, yep, mm-hmm. That was a good fix. Good job. All right.
There's a lot of, and I don't know exactly how you can fix this, but there's a lot of rolling our weight to like more towards the pinky toe of the base foot when we're up in that kick. And I think that's part of why it's falling over too. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, so your foot when you're balancing here, your baby toe is like a, I'm gonna bring my little hand up here. So if you're pushed up on your releve, your baby toe is kind of like a balance point this way. It literally can lift off the ground and not change because this part of your foot is your attachment underneath the baby toe. So if you are not pressing into both sides to where your baby toe can move, we have the chance of rolling into that ankle, okay? So we have to press into the outside points of the ball of our foot and use the toes splaying apart, spreading out as our balance. If you're pushing this way and the big toe can lift off, that's very bad. We do not want our big toe to be able to come off the ground in a releve. Okay, that's part of when we did this at the very beginning class, when you shift your weight, I can still move my baby toe when I'm standing on my big toe. It took a lot of practice, but I still can. So that's something that's very cerebral though, younger dancers. Younger dancers, if you can think about pulling on your, making your knee go toward your hip when you kick, the one that you're standing on, that is gonna help that a lot. Older dancers, you can think about your points of contact a little bit more because you've had a lot more practice with that, theoretically, unless you don't pay attention, then you haven't. So when you go to hit this, squeeze, pull up, squeeze, step through, okay? Yes, okay, that was a lot of kicking. Mara, I was giving you a comment, right? The bottom arm, when you're going to kick, this one is reaching in beautiful and this one's kind of popping at the bottom, so just be careful of that. You weren't the only one, you just like, when I flipped, your little arm went, burp, popped away from your body. Okay, let's, if we have space to do a hinge, we kind of theoretically have space to do a tilt jump, right? All of your favorites. Okay, so a tilt jump, I'm gonna make Miss Morgan Nagel show this one because she can do it. If you guys wanna look at her, you can just go, burp, burp, burp. She's right after you, Allie Huffman. So you can pick, we'll start by going towards the right side and reaching low on the right. So your left leg's high, and then we'll switch and we'll go right leg high. But the idea is that you're doing that hinge kick, pushing the floor away on the bottom leg. So you have your high kick and then you have your push away kick. So Miss Morgan, you can show whichever side you would like. Yeah, do that one more time because the computer's not as fast as your legs. There we go. Thank you for slowing it down a little bit. So did you see how her bottom leg, it doesn't stay hanging down here, it pushes out. Right, so we're doing, what is that called? Seesaw, right? It's an extended seesaw. So we're going push, pull, the bottom leg pushes away from the top leg, but it releases in the hip joint, so you get to whack yourself in the face. You get to. Okay, so stand up. Start by kicking your left leg high or reaching towards the right arm, okay? So we're going, you can start in first position or you can start in fifth position, whichever one's more comfortable for you. We're gonna go from a plie, push through that seesaw, reach, and come down. You're welcome to do them like me and actually do a seesaw. Okay, let's do a couple, ready? Plie, push, land. Look at our bottom hand, just like a tilt kick, We shouldn't be looking up. It's not an arabesque. Ready? Do that again. Plie. Push, land. There we go. Don't drop your chin, though. Keep the space here. Do it again. Ready? Plie. Push, land. Okay, good. Switch legs. I'm seeing a little bit of glissade where we're moving to the foot. We're not moving to the foot. We are jumping, and our momentum is going to push us slightly to the side. Okay, so don't go this way. Don't worry, that was my good leg. I can catch myself there. So we want it to come down where we start. Think about being like in a jazz dance with 10 of your friends, and one of you takes off like a glissade instead of a seesaw. We're in trouble. Like, the formation just changed. Somebody probably got kicked. It's not good. So you got to come up and back down as close to where you started as possible. Okay? So now we're leaning toward our left arm, right leg's high. Ready? 5, 6, 7. Plie, push, and land. 5, 6, 7. Plie, push, and land. Look at that bottom hand immediately. 6, 7. Plie, look, and land. 5, 6, 7. Plie, look, and land. Good. Okay, I'm seeing, I don't know, maybe Alex, you can explain this better, but I'm seeing, like, instead of a diagonal reach of our arms, I'm seeing like a this kind of a feel.
Yeah, it's not just that. What I'm seeing is that we're like crunching in our stomach, so the like everything is contracting and pulling forward. It's not just the shoulders, but it does demonstrate itself on the shoulders. I think that's a part of why it's traveling so much and why they're falling so far forward. Like the ones who are falling forward in their landing, that's why.
Yeah. So you guys are banana-ing again. We're going this way, as opposed to reaching this way.
Yeah, when you lean forward, you can get your leg to go further. It's just disgusting looking. Like, it doesn't actually make it any better. Keeping your body up, like keeping your body stacked and straight, isn't going to let your leg go as high as when you're like contracting over like that, but it's going to look better even though it's not as high as the other one because your position is right.
And technically, you can go higher if you keep yourself straighter because that's where the hip joint opens, is in the front. So I can go this way, but you guys are trying.
I meant to say the leg can go higher.
Oh, it looks higher because of their head.
Yeah.
That. So it's this thing, right? It's like doing, we're folding. So if you can keep your knees stacked on top, you can kick much higher. If you're pulling from your glute on this jump, if it hits your bone hits the top of your pelvis. You can't go. It's never going to get higher. You have to rotate that joint up so it can move. If you don't rotate forward to move, it's just going to keep running into the same spot, and it's going to look like this forever. Okay? So try a couple more. Let's try a couple more. We only have a few minutes left. I want to watch. Should I tell you who I'm watching? Would that be helpful? And then give some corrections, and then you don't have to do 8,000 of them. Okay, cool. We'll do that. Emma, can you do this one, or no? Does this one hurt too much? Hurts too much.
I fell on my elbow, so I went to go get an ice pack.
Okay, well, I won't watch you right now, okay? All right. Olive, not Max. All of you do it this time. Morgan, Garrett, Bree, Adelie, Alyssa, Hoffman. Miranda and Adriana, can I see your tilt jumps? I just want to see your best side twice, or whichever side. Go ahead. On your own. Good. Ooh. There we go. Okay. Adriana, don't do a leap. Do a jump. Jump up and come right back down where you're at. Okay. There you go. Okay.
Good. Control your landing, Lexi.
Yeah. Oh, okay. All of you are doing a little bit of the folding. Bree, that was better. I feel like you're kind of breaking at the top a little bit though. Okay. Morgan, you're good. You're pitching a little at the end. Like you're getting it up there and then it's rotating forward as you come down. So don't do that. Adelie, you got to trust yourself a little bit more. Okay? Trust yourself on that jump. Okay. Miranda, that looks better. You're looking down at your hand now. Adriana, better. Okay, I'm going to switch groups. Max, you can jump up this time. And then Selena, Juniper, Logan, Maddie Heaver, Dia, and Shire. All right. Just show me a couple, whichever side. I just want to give you a couple of tips. Max, look at your bottom hand. Good. Selena, that was good. You're doing a little bit of what Morgan was doing, bringing your leg forward as you land. But, like, don't let that hip rotate forward as you land. Can you guys do a couple more? I'm sorry. Oh, Maddie, that was good. Just don't drop your chin, babe. The jump's good. You're just looking too far down. There you go, Logan. Keep your chest up. Dia, you're doing a little bit of an arabesque. Don't rotate as you kick. Shire, did you finish yours already? Can you do one more jump for me? Can I see one more? Big jump. That was good. That was like a seesaw, like I was doing. Good job. All right, switching groups. We have Charlie, Brooke, Gabby, Grace, Audrey, and Allie Huffman. Do a couple. Give us a chance to watch you. Good. Bigger plie, Gabby. Good. Charlie, stay facing. Keep your belly button forward. Don't go sideways. Brooke, can you reach your arms diagonal when you jump? Good. Audrey, are you starting from coupe? I don't know. Okay, whatever. This is a little bit of a different prep. Good. Allie, don't let your shoulders come up as you kick high because your kick is nice and high. That was better, Audrey. There you go. There you go. All right. Lillian, do one more because I missed it. Did I say your name? I didn't say your name. I said Grace's name, didn't I? Did I say Grace's name? Yes. Okay. Grace, do one more because I missed it. That was who I missed in this corner. Oh, that's good. Okay. So, okay. Here's this weird little thing. Like my advanced dancers, I'm seeing a little bit of a nod. You're like taking off and you're getting to the top and our chin is nodding. And then we're coming down and then we're lifting our chin again. So it's this like, we're like taking off and then we nod at the top and then we come back down again. So it's like, I'm not seeing this pretty shape from you. I'm kind of seeing this shape from you where our head is down. So be careful of that. All right, so now Lillian and Morgan Magel. And I just lost my place. Where was I at? And it switched on me. Did somebody leave?
Okay. It does that.
Okay, sorry. Lynn-Ann, Morgan, Mara, Kaylee, Reagan, London, Lexi. That's probably as many as I can watch at one time. Ready, set, go! Good, Kaylee. Oh, I did it again. Reagan, don't twist forward as you land. Mara, don't die. There you go. That was much better. There, good. Morgan, twist your head and look at your hand. It's almost like you're doing a straddle jump. There you go. There you go.
Kay, don't anticipate the landing. You're bending your knee too early. And Lexi, that's what I was telling you.
There you go. Okay, be careful. London, that's good. Yeah, it's like as we're coming down, we're rotating the hip forward. So when you guys land a seesaw, you don't do that. Like when we do these smaller, we push off and we close where we're going to. But right now we're going push off and we close this way. See how my whole body is rotating? I don't want to see that. I want to see you push off and swing through. Okay, who's my next group? Noah, Danica, are you okay to do it or did it hurt too much? No? Yes? Yes? Okay. Yes. Noah? Yes. Tatum? Macy? Courtney? Avery? Amelia? How about Carter? You go out of your two groups, out of your two-person house. All right, ready? Show me! Go! Do pretty things. Noah, look at your bottom hand, not your top hand. Yep. Good, Macy. You didn't take a nod. I appreciate that. Danica, kick off both legs at the same time. Tatum, that's really pretty. It's just that your top arm is too high. It's not making a dent. Your kicks are nice and high, but your arm's too broken at the shoulder. It needs to reach, okay? Courtney, do one more. I missed it. Good. You're doing that same thing where we're landing too far forward, though. The kick is really pretty. You guys are doing the hard part, right? We're just over-rotating the landing. All right. Good, Avery. Land on a plie, though, so you don't hurt your knee, okay? That's a good kick. Amelia, don't land. You're almost doing like a Dr. Pepper, where your bottom leg is bending a little bit in the air. So push through the floor a little bit. Show me one more. Push through the floor. There, that was better. Carter, that was good. Don't drop your chin. Your kicks are getting much higher, but you're dropping your chin so it doesn't look any higher. Yeah, that side is not quite as good as the other side was. Big hugs. I'm just being honest. There you go. All right, so Brooklyn, Alyssa Lightfoot. Alyssa Huffman, did I watch you yet? Or Alyssa Huffman. Allie Huffman, did I watch you yet? I did watch you, okay. Eliza, I haven't watched you, have I? No? Okay, Ryan, out of your group now. Is that everybody? Ryan, Brooklyn, Eliza, Alyssa Lightfoot. Did I miss anybody? Okay. Ready, jump. Good. Okay. Okay, so Ryan, Eliza, and Alyssa, you all three are doing the landing I was just talking about, where you're kicking off and then it's swinging this way. So instead of landing that foot and keeping your shoulders square, we're kicking and we're swinging that hip in front. Just so you know, all of you are doing it. So that may be something we really need to work on as a team. Brooklyn, can you do one more? You kind of blend in with your background. It's hard to see. Good, okay, watch that back knee. Don't let it bend in, but the kick's nice and high. Keep it in front of your hip. Okay, we're out of time, aren't we? Ooh, we are out of time. We're out of time, we gotta start rehearsal. Musical production, if you're in that, that's first, okay? So stick around, please. Everybody else, we'll see you in a minute.
Is musical production Willy Wonka or?
Yes, ma'am. Mm-hmm. Yeah.